Good morning. Previously, we derived the equations for the equivalent resistance of resistors in series and in parallel. Today, we are going to derive the equations for the equivalent capacitance of capacitors in series and in parallel.
Flippin' physics!
Bo, let's see what you can do with two capacitors in parallel.
Well, those two capacitors are in parallel. Then we know all the electric potential differences are equal in magnitude.
Think about the charges moved by the battery to the plates of the capacitors.
Sure. Because the charges moved by the battery to the top plates of the capacitor need to go to either capacitor 1 or capacitor 2, the charge moved by the battery to the plates of the capacitors equals the sum of the charges on the capacitors. And now we can use the definition of capacitance. Capacitance equals the magnitude of the charge stored on one of the plates of the capacitor over the electric potential difference across the plates of the capacitor. That means charge equals capacitance times electric potential difference, which we can substitute into the charge equation to get equivalent capacitance times terminal voltage equals the sum of the capacitance of each capacitor times the electric potential difference across each capacitor. And because the electric potential differences are all equal,
everybody brought electric potential difference to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
And we get that the equivalent capacitance of two capacitors in parallel equals the sum of the capacitance of the two parallel capacitors.
Correct, Bo. And a more general equation for the equivalent capacitance of n, a variable number of capacitors in parallel, equals the summation of the capacitance of n number of capacitors. You just add up the capacitance of all the parallel capacitors. All right, let's move on to two capacitors in series. Bobby, it's your turn again.
Okay, we know the electric potential difference equation is the same as for two resistors in series. Terminal voltage equals voltage across capacitor 1 plus voltage across capacitor 2. And looking at the charges moved by the battery to the plates of the capacitors, well, we know the magnitude of the charge moved by the battery to the top plate of capacitor 1 and the magnitude of the charge moved to the bottom plate of capacitor 2 are equal in magnitude. But what happens then? I mean, how would any charge get on the bottom plate of capacitor 1 and the top plate of capacitor 2? Those two plates are connected by a wire, and that whole system is not physically connected to any part of the circuit.
There are already electric charges located there on the wire and the two plates of the capacitor, right?
Okay, yes. So negative charges are pulled to the bottom plate of capacitor 1 by the positive charges on the top plate of capacitor 1. And positive charges are pulled to the top plate of capacitor 2 by the negative charges on the bottom plate of capacitor 2. That's cool.
Yeah, that area gets polarized by the top plate of capacitor 1 and the bottom plate of capacitor 2. That is cool.
Yeah, and that means that the charges on all the plates of those capacitors are equal in magnitude. In other words, the total charge moved by the battery equals the charge on capacitor 1, which equals the charge on capacitor 2. That's basically just conservation of charge, right, Mr. P?
Exactly, Bobby.
Yeah. Okay. Using the equation for capacitance, we can show the electric potential difference across a capacitor equals the magnitude of the charge on one of the plates of a capacitor over the capacitance of the capacitor. We can substitute that into our electric potential difference equation. All the charges are the same, so
everybody brought charge to the party.
We are partying a lot today.
Yes, we are.
I like it.
Everybody brought mass.
That means one capacitor with an equivalent capacitance of two capacitors in series equals the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the capacitance of the two series capacitors.
Perfect, Bobby. Thanks. And a more general equation for the equivalent capacitance of n, a variable number of capacitors in series, equals the inverse of the sum of the inverses of the capacitance of n number of capacitors. You just add up the inverses of the capacitances of all the series capacitors and take the inverse of that. Now, looking at the general concept of capacitors in series and in parallel, from the equations you can see that when we add capacitors in series, the equivalent capacitance goes down, and when we add capacitors in parallel, the equivalent capacitance goes up. Please notice the series and parallel equations for resistors and capacitors are reversed. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.